Have a nice day, my dear student. Today we will discuss about the starting method, losses, efficiency, and braking of a DC motor, which is lecture 11 of electrical machine. Day by day, I will cover all the syllabus of electrical machine. This is the last topic of electrical motor, and myself, Mr. Shantanu Naskar, Assistant Professor of Electrical Department, GKCEM, JIS Group, and my mail ID is shantanu.uyt@gmail.com and shantanu.naskar_gkcem@jisgroup.org. And this is my Facebook page, Being Electrified with Shantanu. So first of all, we will discussing about the syllabus. So this is the last topic of DC motor, starting method of DC motor, 3-point and 4-point starter, losses and efficiency, and braking method of DC generator, which is regenerative braking, counter current braking, which is flagging, and dynamic braking. And my all DC motor lecture, I described and discussed about the application of different types of DC motor. So today, this is the last topic of my lecture of DC motor. After that, I will start single phase transformer. So start. So at first, we have to know why we need starter to start the DC motor. Okay, so here this is the equation of a DC motor, V equals to EB plus IARA, where V is the terminal voltage, EB is the back EMF, and IA is the armature current, RA is the armature resistance. From here we can write EB equals to V minus IARA. Okay, now at the starting, when motor is stationary, there is no back EMF in the armature. That's mean IA equals to V minus EB by RA, and at the starting there is no back EMF. That's mean this EB is zero, so IA equals to V by RA. Okay, now look here, armature resistance is very small. Now voltage of DC motor is constant, like 230. Now if an example, 5 horsepower 220 volt shunt motor has a full current of 20 ampere and a armature resistance of 0.5 ohm, if this motor is directly switched on to the supply, it would take an armature current of 220 by 0.5. From this equation we can get the value of armature current, which is 440 ampere, which is 22 times the full load current. This is so high for a starting current. It may result in burning of armature due to excessive heating effect, damaging the commutator and brushes due to heavy sparking, excessive voltage drop in the line to which the motor is connected. The result is that the operation of other application connected to the line may be impaired, and in particular cases they may refuse to work. So that means the starting current is very, very high, 22 times of the full load current. Okay, that's why we have to, in order to avoid the excessive current at starting, a variable resistance known as starting resistance, this is the starting resistance, is inserted in series with the armature circuit. This resistance is gradually reduce as the motor gains speed, and hence EB is increased, and eventually it is cut out completely when the motor has attained full speed. The value of starting resistance is generally such that starting current is limited to 1.25 to 2 times of the full load current. So every time is back EMF, not the disadvantage of DC motor. Sometimes it acts like an advantage of DC motor. So if there is no back EMF is zero, look, the situation of current is become very high, so it can affect the DC motor. So back EMF is needed, and also for this starter is needed. Okay, so after this, types of DC motor starting. So there are two types of DC motor starting or starter. One is 3-point starter, another is 4-point starter. I will discuss about these two type of starter very thoroughly. So first, the 3-point starter, because of there are 3-point LFA, so it's called 3-point starter, and this has 4-point LNFA, so it's called 4-point starter. Okay, now come to the 3-point starter. So a 3-point starter is a device, just go through this peak, that helps in the starting and running of a DC shunt motor or compound wound DC motor, similar to a 4-point starter. Now question is, why this type of DC motor requires the assistance of starter in the first place? Well, it's due to the presence of back EMFEB, which plays a critical role in governing of the operation of the motor. Okay, the back EMF develops as the motor armature starts to rotate in presence of the magnetic field by generating action and counter supply voltage. Hence the back EMF at the starting of the motor is zero, which I have discussed in my previous slide. Why we need starter? Okay, here. So come to the main thing, the 3-point starter. Okay, so to understand how the starting current is restricted to the desired value, we need to look at the construction and working principle of 3-point starter. So the electrical symbol in the diagram here, so all the essential parts of the 3-point starter. Now first, the construction of 3-point starter. Construction wise, a starter is a variable resistance integrated into the number of section as shown in the figure. The contact point of this section are called stud. These and are shown separately as off. Look here, off 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and run. Other than that, there are three main points referred to as line terminal connected to the positive of supply. This is the line, L for line. Number two, armature terminal connected to the armature of the machine, and field terminal F. This field terminal connected to the field winding. So 3-point L, which is connected to the positive supply of the line, F, which is connected to the field winding, and armature terminal, which is connected to the armature winding. Okay, and from there it gets the name 3-point starter. So why the name is 3-point starter, you just understand. Now studying the construction of 3-point starter in further details reveals that the point L is connected to an electromagnet called overload release. This is called overload release. Okay, this is an electromagnet as shown in this figure. The other end of Euler is connected to the lower end of conducting lever of starter handle, where spring is also attached with it, and the starter handle also contained a soft iron piece housed on it. This is the soft iron piece. This handle is free to move to the other side, run against the force of the spring. The spring brings back the handle to its original off position under the influence of its own force. Another parallel path is derived from the stud 1 given to another electromagnet coil, which is called no volt coil NVC, which is further connected to terminal F, which is connected to field terminal. The starting resistance at starting is entirely in series with the armature. This resistance entirely in series with the armature. Look here, this all resistance. The OLR and NVC, OLR means overload release coil, NVC means no fault coil, act as the two protecting device of the starter. Okay, now the working of the 3-point starter. Having studied its construction, let us now go into the working of the 3-point starter. Now, to start with, the handle is in the off position. When the supply to the DC motor is switched on, the handle is slowly moved against the spring force to make contact with stud 1. Okay. At this point, field winding of the shunt or the compound motor gets supply through the parallel path provided to starting the resistance through no voltage coil, while entire starting resistance comes in series with the armature. The high starting armature current thus get limited as the current equation at this stage become Ia equals to V by Ra plus Rst. Okay. As the handle is moved further, it goes on making contact to start 2, 3, 4, etc., thus gradually cutting off the series resistance from the armature circuit as the motor gather the speed. That means the motor gathering the speed. Finally, when the starter handle is in run position, this handle is in run position, the entire starting resistance is eliminated and the motor runs with normal speed. This is because back EMF is developed consequently with speed to counter the supply voltage and reduce the armature current. So the external electrical resistance is not required anymore and is removed for optimum operation. The handle is moved manually from off to run position with the development of speed. Now the obvious question is, once the handle is taken to the run position, how it is supposed to stay there? Okay, as long as the motor is running, how it is supposed to stay there? To find the answer of this question, let us look into the working of no voltage coil. Now, working of no voltage coil. To supply the field winding is derived through no voltage coil. So when current flows, the no voltage coil is magnetized. Now when the handle is in the run position, a soft iron piece is connected to the handle and gets attracted by the magnetic force produced by the no voltage coil because of flow of current through it. The no voltage coil is designed in such way that it holds the handle in run position.
against the force of the spring as long as supply is given to the motor. Thus, no voltage coil holds the handle in the run position and hence also called hold on coil. Now, when there is any kind of supply failure, the current flow through no voltage coil is affected and it immediately loses its magnetic property and is unable to keep the soft iron piece on the handle. Okay. At this point, under the action of spring force, the handle comes back free to the off position. So, this handle become in the off position, opening the circuit and thus switching of the motor. So, due to the combination of NVC, NVC means no voltage coil, and the spring, the starter handle always come back to off position whenever there is any supply problem. Thus, it is also act as a protective device, safeguarding the motor from any kind of abnormality. Now, the last drawbacks of the 3-point starter. The 3-point starter suffers from a serious drawback for motors with large variation of speed by adjustment of field rheostat to increase the speed of the motor, field resistance can be increased. Therefore, current through the shunt field is reduced. Field current becomes very low, which result in holding electromagnet too weak to overcome the force exerted by the spring. The holding magnet may release the arm of the starter during the normal operation of the motor and thus disconnect the motor from the line. This is not desirable. A 4-point motor is thus used instead, which does not have this types of drawback. Now we will discuss about the 4-point starter. Before knowing about 4-point starter, you have to know the working principle of a 4-point starter. So, a 4-point starter protects the armature of a DC shunt motor or compound wound DC motor against the initially high starting current of the DC motor. The 4-point starter has a lot of constructional and functional similarity to a 3-point starter, but this special device have an additional point and coil in its construction, as the name suggests. This bring about some difference in its function, and though the basic operational characteristics remain the same, the basic difference in the circuit of a 4-point starter as compared to 3-point starter is that the holding coil is removed from the shunt field current and is connected directly across the resistance. So, look here, the holding coil resistance connected the resistance in series. Okay, now to go into the details of the 4-point starter or the operation of 4-point starter, let's have a look at its construction diagram. This will help demonstrate the difference between 4 versus 3, that means 4-point starter versus 3-point starter. So, the construction. 4-point starter, as the name suggests, has four main operational points, namely L is line terminal connected to positive of supply, A armature terminal connected to armature winding, F field terminal connected to field winding. Like in the case 3-point starter, and in addition to it, there is a fourth point N connected to the no voltage coil NVC. So, this is the additional point. So, that's why the name is 4-point starter. Okay. Now, the remarkable difference in case of 4-point starter is that the no voltage coil is connected independently across the supply through the fourth terminal called N in addition to the LFA. Okay. As a direct consequence of that, any change in the field supply current does not bring about any difference in the performance of the NVC no volt coil. Thus, it must be ensured that no voltage coil always produces a force which is strong enough to hold the handle in its run position against the force of the spring under all the operational conditions. Such a current is adjusted through no voltage coil with the help of fixed resistance R connected in series with the NVC using fourth point N as shown in the figure here. Apart from these above mentioned fact, the 4-point and 3-point starter are similar in all other ways, like possessing is a variable resistance integrated into number of section as shown in the figure. The contact point of this section are called start are as shown separately as of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 run over which the handle is free to be maintained manually to regulate the starting current with gathering speed. Now to understand its way of operating, let's have a closer look at the diagram. Considering that supply is given and the handle is taken, start number 1, then circuit is complete and the line current that starts flowing through the starter. In this situation we can see that the current will divide it into three parts following through three different points. Number one part flows through the starting resistance R1 plus R2 plus R3 like this and then to the armature, and a second part flowing through the field winding F, and the third part flowing through the no voltage coil in the series with the appropriate resistance R. So point to be noted here is that with this particular arrangement, any change in the shunt field circuit does not bring about any change in the no voltage coil, as the two circuits are independent of each other. The essentially means that the electromagnet pull subjected upon the soft iron bar of the handle by the no voltage coil at all points of time should be high enough to keep the handle at its run position, or rather prevent the spring force from restoring the handle at its original off position irrespective or now sorry how the field rheostat is adjusted. This marks the operational difference between 4-point starter and 3-point starter, as otherwise both are almost similar and are used for limiting the starting current to a shunt wound DC motor or compound wound DC motor and thus act as a protective device. Next slide is about the losses of DC motor. So start. Here we discuss about the different types of losses in DC machine as well as it is called DC generator or DC motor, all are DC machine. So in a DC generator converts mechanical power into electrical power, and DC motor converts electrical power into mechanical power. Thus for a DC generator, input power is in the form of mechanical and the output power is in the form of electrical. On the other hand, for a DC motor, input power is in the form of electrical and the output power is in the form of mechanical. In practical machine, whole of the input power cannot be converted into output power, as some power is lost in the conversion process. This causes the efficiency of machine which to be reduced. Efficiency is the ratio of output power to the input power. Thus, in order to design rotating DC machine or any electrical machine with higher efficiency, it is important to study losses occurring in them. Various losses in a rotating DC machine. DC machine means DC generator and DC motor. Okay. After this losses, we will discuss about the efficiency. So, what type of losses are there? Losses in DC machine are three types: copper loss, iron loss, mechanical loss. Copper loss has three types: armature copper loss, shunt field copper loss, and series field copper loss. And iron loss, which is called core loss, also has two types: hysteresis loss, eddy current loss. And mechanical loss have two types: friction loss, windage loss. Okay. So one by one I will discuss about all types of loss. So first of all, copper loss. These losses occur in armature and field copper winding. Copper loss consists of armature copper loss, field copper loss, and loss due to brass contact resistance. Armature copper loss equals to I square Ra, where Ia is the armature current, Ra is the armature resistance. This loss contributes about 30 to 40% to full load losses. The armature copper loss is variable and depends upon the amount of loading of the machine. Now, field copper loss. Field copper loss is equal to IF square RF, where IF equals to field current and RF equals to field resistance. In the case of a shunt wounded field, field copper loss is practically constant. It contributes about 20 to 30% to full load losses. Brass contact resistance also contributes to the copper losses. Generally, this loss is included into armature copper loss. Okay. Next, core loss, which is also called iron loss. As the armature core is made of iron and it rotates in a magnetic field, a small current gets induced in the core itself too. Due to this current, eddy current loss and hysteresis loss occur in the armature iron core. Iron losses are also called core losses or magnetic losses. Hysteresis loss. So core loss is two types, hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. Now hysteresis loss. Hysteresis loss is due to the reversal of magnetizing of the armature core. When the core passes under one pair of poles, it undergoes one complete cycle of magnetic reversal. The frequency of magnetic reversal is given by F equals to Pn by 120, where P is the number of pole, N is the speed in the RPM, and the loss depends upon the volume and grade of the iron, frequency of magnetic reversal, and value of flux density. Hysteresis loss is given by this formula. Ph equals to this sign is called Steinman's hysteresis constant. So B max to the power 1.6 Fb, where B max is equal to magnetic maximum magnetic flux density, and F equal to frequency, V equals to volume of the core in meter cube. Now the eddy current loss. Because of this is loss, so unit is in watt. The watt loss is a power, okay. That's why we have to calculate the losses in open circuit and short circuit test. From watt meter reading, we got the losses. Now, eddy current loss. When the armature core rotates in the magnetic field and EMF is also induced in the core, just like it induced in armature conductor, according to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, though this is induced EMF is small, it causes a large current to flow in the body due to the low resistance of the core. This current is known as eddy current. The power loss due to this current is also known as eddy current loss. So this is the formula of eddy current, and these are the two picture of eddy current and hysteresis loss. So this is hysteresis loss BH curve, and this is eddy current. Eddy means just move like is round, okay. The movement like rounding movement is called AD. So the formula is P equals to KE. This is constant B square M, T square F square V, where Bm equal to maximum magnetic flux density, T is thickness, F is frequency, V is volume. So next is the basic comparison between eddy current loss hysteresis. Plus, just look at definition. The loss occur eddy current. The loss occur because of the relative motion between the core and the magnetic flux. hysteresis, the losses which occur because of the reversal of the magnetism is known as the hysteresis loss. These are the formula we discuss about that occur interaction of magnetic flux and conductor, hysteresis because of reversal of flux, minimizing method by making the core of thin lamination, and this should be by using silicon steel material. Now mechanical loss. Nothing but mechanical loss consists of losses due to friction in bearings and commutator. Air friction, loss of rotation, armature also contribute to this. These losses are about 10 to 20% of full load loss. Now stray losses. Stray losses is in addition to the losses stated above, there may be small losses present which are called as stray losses or miscellaneous losses. These losses are difficult to account. They are usually due to inaccuracies in the designing and modeling of the machine. Most of the time stray losses are assumed to be 1% of the full load. Okay. Now power flow diagram. The most convenient method to understand the losses in DC generator or DC motor is using power flow diagram. The diagram visualizes the amount of power that has been lost in various type of losses and the amount of power which has been actually converted into the output. Following are the typical power flow diagram of DC generator and DC motor. So look here, nothing, just for DC generator, mechanical power is the input, then mechanical losses occur after in the core losses occur, after copper losses occur, stray losses occur, then the output is electrical. Like this, the motor electrical is the input, like then copper loss, core loss, then mechanical loss, stray loss, and the output is mechanical power. Okay, so this is the power flow diagram. Now the efficiency. Efficiency is nothing but I discussed about efficiency before in one of my slide. So percentage efficiency is power output by power input into 100. Because of this percentage, we have to multiply with 100. So this equals to power output equals to input minus losses by power input into 100, or we can write power output by power output plus losses into 100. So efficiency is maximum when variable loss and constant loss is same. Remember this thing, variable loss equals to constant loss. So go to the next slide. My next slide is about the references of this lecture, which is Electrical Machine by Asfaq Hussain and Harun Asfaq, Dhanpad Rai and Company. This book is very good book for electrical machine diploma and BTEC engineer. And then Principle of Electrical Machine by V.K. Mehta and Rohit Mehta. This is very simple and easy. If you have any doubt about electrical machine, you can go through this book. This is number 2. And the most important book, the best book according to my choice, is Electrical Machinery by Dr. P.S. Bhimra. This book is very good but little bit tough for diploma engineers, but easy for BTEC engineers. And also in MTEC you can also go through this book. Okay, so some good site, electrical for you, and electrical is easy, and NPTEL's videos. So this is my Facebook page, Being Electrified with Santanu, and this is my YouTube channel, Being Electrified. You can like my Facebook page and subscribe my YouTube channel. So thank you. Hope you all enjoy my lecture. Thank you.